Now I shall take application of impulse momentum equation for impact of jets. Case 1. Impact of liquid on a fixed vertical plate in the direction normal to it. As shown in this figure, if this is the fixed flat plate grounded, this symbol shows that plate cannot move. This is the jet having the diameter D. D is the diameter of the jet. Jet is impinging the plate in the normal direction to it, fixed plate, with a velocity v. After impinging the plate, the jet will leave along the tangential direction to the plate after gliding over the plate. Assume steady flow of jet. Now our objective is to get what is the force Fx exerted by the jet on the plate. What is the force exerted by the jet on the plate in the x direction? I have shown the direction of x. This is x direction. This is plate. Now, impulse momentum equation could be applied to this particular case, or you can write the Newton's second law of motion. Newton's second law of motion states Fx is equal to MAx. Fx is equal to force exerted by jet on plate along x direction is equal to mass into change in velocity along x direction divided by time. But mass by time is equal to mass flow rate in kg per second. Therefore, Fx is equal to mass flow rate into change in velocity along x direction. But mass flow rate from steady flow, it can be written as rho into q, where that is rho av, so many kg per second, where a is equal to pi by 4 d square, that is area of jet. V is the velocity of jet impinging, rho is the density of liquid in kg per meter cube. Therefore, Fx is equal to rho av into change in velocity along x direction. What is the initial velocity along x direction? That is v. What is the final velocity leaving the plate along x direction? 0. It comes to rho av square newtons. Since plate is fixed, there is no displacement, hence work done is equal to zero. Since even though displacement is there, even though there is force, work done is zero. Work done by the jet on the plate is zero. Here Fy, force along y direction will be, inlet momentum entering is along y direction is 0 minus exit momentum leaving along positive y direction is m dot into v by 2 upwards minus m dot into v by 2 downwards. They cancel each other. Net force along the y direction is 0 because exit momentum leaving at the two ends, they are in the opposite direction along y direction. While leaving, they cancel each other. Anyhow, there is no momentum entering along y direction at the inlet. This is the control volume we can take. The dotted portion what I had shown in the figure can be taken as control volume. So there is no momentum along entering the control volume along y direction, but the exit momentum leaving along y direction, there are two parts. One is going upwards, positive, one other is going downwards. They cancel each other. Therefore, net momentum leaving in the y direction is zero. Therefore, net force acting along the y direction is zero. Case 2. Force exerted by jet of liquid or water on inclined plate. So this is the inclined plate. This is the jet of water coming with a velocity v. Let this angle be theta. D is the diameter of the jet. This is a jet of water. Now our objective is to get the force exerted by the jet along x and y directions. This is x. Now I consider a normal direction to the plate. This is a normal direction to plate. Now let us calculate the force exerted by jet on plate along normal direction, that is Fn. From Newton's second law, Fn is equal to MAN, mass into acceleration along normal direction. Fn is equal to M into change in velocity along normal direction. That is M dot into change in velocity along normal direction. that is m dot is rho q to delta v along normal, that is rho av into what is the initial velocity along normal direction. It becomes, this angle will be 90 minus theta, v cos 90 minus theta will be v sin theta, v sin theta, because jet leaves the plate after gliding over it in the tangential direction or parallel direction to the plate, their component along the normal direction is 0. It becomes rho a v square sin theta, so many newtons. Therefore, Fx is equal to Fn cos 90 minus theta, Fn sin theta, rho a v square sin square theta. This is the direction of Fn. Its component along x direction is, this is x direction. Therefore, Fn cos 90 minus theta is Fn sin theta. Also, Fy is equal to Fn, one component being sin, other component will be cos. That is rho a v square sin theta cos theta. If we put theta is equal to 90 degrees in the above equations, we get the formulae for case 1, that is vertical plate. We put theta is equal to 90 degrees here, we would be obtaining the previous case, that is case 1, which is a vertical flat plate case. Hence the problem. Now I shall take another case, that is case 3. Impact of jet over a symmetrical curved vane with the jet impinging at its center. The vane are being fixed, the vane or bucket being fixed. That is shown in the pictorial form like this. If this is the curved vane which is grounded, jet is impinging at the center with a velocity v. As assumed earlier, d is the diameter of the jet. After impinging, jet will leave the, after gliding over the vane, it will leave in this direction. This angle is theta. Of course, theta is same on both sides. Area of jet is pi by 4 d square, which is A. Rho is density of jet water or liquid. It is grounded. After impinging, the vane, the jet glides over the vane and leaves it tangentially at its tip, at its tips. this is the direction of x. Our objective is to get what is fx. To get fx, from Newton's second law, fx is max, implies fx is equal to m by time into change in velocity along x direction. This is mass flow rate into change in velocity along x direction. Mass flow rate into, what is the change in velocity along x direction? Initial velocity along x direction is v minus of minus v cos theta, because this v is leaving this way, neglecting friction. Here assume steady flow and no friction, no friction between the jet and the vane. That is the reason why the jet is leaving at its exit with the same velocity v, whatever it is impinging. After impinging at its center, it is leaving with the same velocity because friction is neglected. So it becomes m dot is rho av. From continuity equation, m dot is rho av, m dot is mass flow rate into v plus v cos theta. It is rho av square into 1 plus cos theta. So many meters. Fy is again 0. This is the x direction, this will be y direction. Fy is 0. No work done here by jet. Since vane is fixed. If we put theta is equal to 90 degrees, cos 90 is 0, we get case 1, where vertical flat plate case. If you put theta is equal to 90 degrees, we will be getting the very first case of a fixed vertical plate. Hence the problem. Now I shall consider next case. Impact of jet over a symmetrical fixed curved vane with the jet entering the vane tangentially at one of its tip and leaving at the other. This case could be pictorially represented as, if this is the symmetrical curved vane, fixed curved vane, the jet is entering tangentially at one of its tips and leaving at the other tip after flowing over the vane. This is the jet. D is the diameter of the jet. Now you are interested in calculating the force along x direction. Now to get effects, let theta is equal to angle of vane with respect to x direction. That is, if this is x direction, if you extend the tangent direction to the tip, this angle made is theta, which will be same for both sides. That is, if we draw the tangent to tip of the vanes, that will be intersecting the x direction with an angle theta. Now, from Newton's second law, Fx is equal to max, m into change in velocity along x direction divided by time. But mass by time is equal to m dot, that is mass flow rate, which is given as density into discharge, which can be given as rho into A into V, where A is equal to pi by 4 d square, that is area of jet, implies Fx is equal to rho AV into change in velocity of the jet along x direction from inlet to exit, rho AV into V cos theta, because this angle will be theta, that is at inlet along x direction, minus of minus V cos theta. It becomes 2V cos theta, rho AV into 2V cos theta, that is 2 rho AV square cos theta. So many Newtons. Here also no work done, since displacement is 0. Why? Vane is grounded. 2 rho AV square cos theta newtons. That is the force exerted by the jet along x direction. Now I shall do a problem given in GATE 2003. The problem is given like this. A water container is kept on a weighing balance. Water from a tap is falling vertically into the container with a volume flow rate of Q. The velocity of water when it hits the water surface is u. at a particular instant of time, the total mass of the container and water is M. The force registered by the weighing balance at this instant of time is A, mg plus rho qu B, mg plus 2 rho qu C, mg plus rho q u square by 2 D, rho q u square by 2. This is a gate problem given in gate 2003. Now this is the tap. I suppose this is the tap. Water falling into the water container. This is the tap. The velocity of water when it hits the water surface is u. After hitting, the water will be just spreading horizontally. So I consider this is the control volume. The thick line, whatever I had shown, is the control volume CV. So the velocity of water entering control volume in a vertical direction is U. Also, velocity of water leaving control volume along y direction is 0. Everything is kept on a weighing balance. This is weighing balance. Therefore, there is no exit momentum leaving the control volume in the y direction. So the only rate of momentum entering control volume along y direction is rho qu so many newtons. Therefore, the reading of the force registered by balance is equal to mg plus impact force of jet on balance in vertical direction. Therefore, what is the impact force is equal to rate of momentum entering rho qu minus 0. This is the impact force. Therefore, total force is equal to mg plus rho qu so many newtons. Hence the problem. There is no momentum leaving the control volume in y direction. All the momentum is along the x direction. If you look at the control volume, the fact is clear.